my lunch. I got an hour for lunch, so I'm gonna be banging this out. Cause
miss it. Miss playing. I'm dying.
I did a bunch of off camera, off video, just leveling. I just ran around in front of this building, the opening to this building, the opening to Guadosalam. By a bunch, I don't mean a ton. I just, you know. A ferocious storm is ripping through the thunder plains. Please remain inside. Okay, so that goes down to the thunder plains. It's probably the next place we go after all this. Treasure chest back here. Got a mega potion. I've been getting a lot of mega potions stealing from all the treasure chests outside during battles. So that's cool. If I steal from the thick boys, sometimes they give me a hypello potion, I believe it's called. My work computer has done some weird stuff. Maybe kicked me out of some things because I'm no longer connected to the internet on it. Anyway, yeah, so it's going here. And then the frost blobs are giving me something cold. What was it called? Antarctic winds. So I've been getting a bunch of those. I got a stamina tablet from something I stole. I think it was probably from a chest. Doubles the max HP. I'm assuming that just means for one fight. Because, dang. Dragon scale I've been getting from the chest. And yeah. But yeah, I got some more hit points for Riku. It's always been very helpful.
These are the past leaders of the Guado.
They all look the same.
Maester Seymour doesn't look like them, no.
Don't you know? The last leader, Maester Jiskel, wed a human woman. She was Seymour's mother.
Oh. Hmm.
Oh, I guess that's the end of that. Interesting. We are in a two-story circular room. Like, everything here is all... There's a lot of tree. So, like, there's a lot of bark. There's a lot of, like, tree... kind of like thin roots that are creating designs in the floor. They're all along the staircase here. Like, the staircase kind of looks like it was made out of metal, maybe, at one point. But then tree roots have just climbed over everything. Other than that, there's like a lot of purples and blues and kind of reds, like muted reds. Everything else is tree colored. But there's a spiral staircase. There's a staircase on either side leading up to the second level. A curved staircase around the circular room. Orin.
Stay close to Yuna.
Okay. Riku.
I wonder what smells so nice.
Probably all the tree stuff. Where's Waka? Waka's over here. Let's go up the stairs and talk to Waka.
I don't like the smell of this one, eh?
Treasure chest up here, kind of hidden. Two half potions. Let's go talk to Yuna, see what happens. Or Kimari first.
Kimari not like Mr. Seymour.
Yeah, join the club, kid.
Shh. Shh, don't say anything. Don't say it out loud, Kimari.
Said the quiet part out loud.
Why does he want to see me?
Try to go in this door in the bottom level, big old purple door.
This way, please.
Trumel. Seymour's servant guy, I guess. Okay, we'll go your direction. We'll go the way you want us to go, bro. Just this once, though.
I will go inform Lord Seymour. Please wait here.
So many doors. So now we're in another circular room. The only real wood you kind of have appears kind of around the doors and above it. Well, at least visible wood, maybe unpainted wood. And then in the floor, too, some patterns that the roots kind of make. There's a big, a lot of, there's this giant circular fruit table.
This is cool.
Riku is partaking. I always talk to Yuna last, because she might be the one that, oh.
There's no temple here in Guadosalam, see? Summoners usually just pass through on their way elsewhere. What?
I didn't even ask a question and you're explaining things.
You'd rather I say nothing, then?
No.
Maybe you finally believe I don't know anything about Spira.
And maybe that means you believe me about Zanarkand, too?
Well, there are many things I do not know. Your Zanarkand is one of those things. I suppose I can't say what I think, either way. Still, be careful. You shouldn't tell other people.
Yeah, I know.
She's coming over to your side.
Stay on your guard.
Why? This guy's just a priest, right?
Those with power use that power. Maesters have power.
Wait. You sure you don't have something against Yevon?
I lived a long time in Zanarkand.
Ah.
I get the feeling he called us up here for more than just dinner.
Spheres in the ceiling that are kind of glowy, purpley, whitish lights.
Truly, it is good to have guests again.
Since Lord Giskel passed away, these halls have been too quiet.
The death of Lord Giskel was a great loss for all of Spira.
Was this Maester Giskel really such a great guy?
He brought the teachings of Yevon to the Guado. He was truly a great man.
Truly a loss for us all. But now, a new leader, Lord Seymour, has come before us. Lord Seymour is the child of a Guado and a human. He will be the tie that binds our two races together. But that is not all, I think. Lord Seymour, he will surely become the shining star that lights the way for all the peoples of Spira.
That is enough trouble. Must I always endure such praise?
Gross.
Welcome!
You wanted to see me?
Please, make yourselves at home. There's no rush.
Please keep this short. Yuna must rush.
Pardon me. It has been a long time since I had guests. Lady Yuna, this way.
In a full motion video, Yuna has walked down into darkness, and then it's lit up with, like, kind of blue comets kind of coming out of this, and then we see there's a solar system, we see a planet, we see kind of the Milky Way kind of thing, kind of swirling around like it's another galaxy.
This sphere is a reconstruction created from the thoughts of the dead that wander the far.
He's walked up and Yuna kind of shook the banner, but now we're seeing Zanarkand in all of its beautiful glory. And then you see people walking through. This is kind of like a giant hologram sphere.
Zanarkand?
Correct. Zanarkand, as it looked 1,000 years ago.
Just tons of technology everywhere. Holograms everywhere.
great and wondrous machina city, Zanarkand. She once lived in this metropolis.
She who?
Yunalesca? We're back into regular graphics. I mean, the hologram seems to be
gone. Lady Yunalesca.
She was the first person to defeat sin and save the world from its ravages. And you have inherited her name.
It was my father who named me.
Lord Braska was entrusting you with a great task. He wanted you to face sin as Lady Yunalesca did.
She's sitting on a bed.
However, Lady Yunalesca did not save the world alone. To defeat the undefeatable sin, it took an unbreakable bond of love, of the kind that binds two hearts for eternity.
And there's a man walking into her room, very royally garbed, like a golden headgear. He and Lady Yunalesca embrace. Yuna looks a bit shy. Seymour kind of looks at her. Lady Yunalesca is very scantily clad, like basically a bikini, and then like long white hair in intricate patterns and kind of a golden headdress a little bit. We see Seymour is whispering something to Yuna. She covers her mouth. Seymour looks very full of himself. Yuna's head is down. She's kind of like moving her head around, thinking, maybe kind of worried or unsure what to do. Screen flashes white. Now we see a full motion video, but not the same quality. Yuna still kind of head bowed a bit and then walks away from Seymour. And then kind of paces a little bit around the room. Still unsure what to do, takes a drink or something. A big drink or something. Needed some water, I suppose. And then she runs kind of toward Titus and Riku. Waka.
Wow, your face is beet red.
You okay?
He asked me to marry him.
You serious? Hey!
You know what Yuna must do.
Of course. Lady Yuna. No. All summoners are charged with bringing peace to Spira. But this means more than just defeating sin. She must ease the suffering of all Spira. She must be a leader for the people. I proposed to Lady Yuna as a maester of Yevon.
Spira is no playhouse. A moment's diversion may amuse an audience, but it changes nothing.
Even so, the actors must play their parts. There's no need to answer right away. Please, think it over.
We will do so then. We leave.
Lady Yuna! I await your favorable reply.
I don't know why Orin has this left.
Why are you still here, sir?
Kind of up in a sling.
I beg your pardon. We Guado are keen to the scent of the Farplane.
Titus sniffs Orin. Or it shoves him away. Riku grabs a couple fruits. Fruit? Grabs some fruit. A couple fruits. For the way home. Or the way out, whatever.
Yuna, the High Summoner's daughter. Seymour, the leader of the Guado. Married in the name of Yevon, overcoming the barriers of race. It would give Spira something cheery to talk about for a change.
Sounds just like a passing daydream, like Auron says.
Come on, let's just get on with the pilgrimage. I mean, marriage?
Jealous?
What? No way. We gotta defeat Sin. Romance can wait.
You sure picked a fine time to lay this one on us.
Maybe it is a fine time.
You serious?
If my getting married would help Spira? If it would make people happy?
Ever the selfless,
If I could do that for people, maybe I should do what I can. I never imagined doing anything like this. But I won't answer till I know what's right.
Seriously?
You could always just quit your pilgrimage and get married.
I will. Go on. I'm sure that Lord Seymour will understand.
I guess so.
I am a summoner. I must fight and defeat Sin.
Like Braska before you.
I had to stop myself from shouting.
What's there to think about?
I'm going to the Farplane. I'm going to see my father and think on this.
Go on. We'll be right behind you.
I wondered why none of the others ever asked Yuna. Do you love Seymour? Do you even like him?
It's this way. This way is down. Have I been in here? This is the inn, right? This is the shop. I've been in here, sorta. We go out to help the warrior monks patrol the roads beyond. Why wouldn't we do all we can for the good of Spear? Noi is already contracted with the Guados.
Can't get enough? Like to hear.
No, very good.
Pity.
Get out of the way, Nietzsche. Who are you? Thank you so much for destroying the ally. Yeah, I already talked to you. Shalinda already talked to you. Maybe later. Let's save. Plenty of time to do the next part, but there's some stuff. I gotta go back to Seymour's house. I guess there was part of it that I missed some stuff. There's a residence. No. Oh wait, left side? Are you on this side? No. Okay. Is there something up here I can go into? Is this the Farplane? Private chambers, okay. No. So maybe it's outside, there's a residence somewhere out here. Let's go up the stairs, or up the ramp here. And then left, oh here we go, here's the residence. I'm going up a ramp to the left outside of Seymour's palace thing. What are you doing down here? Okay. Talk to you? You find it difficult telling us Guado apart, don't you? No? I suppose you think we all look the same. No? Not really. As sole protectors of the Farplane, the Guado are the supreme race of spirit. Wow, we are fundamentally different from the populace, humans, and the hulking Ronzo. But that's an old story. Now the Guado seek harmony with other races. Thus, welcome human and Ronzo without prejudice. Okay, you got nothing better to say now. Actually, we Guado tend to have trouble telling one human from another, too. Okay. I'd love to step away from the Guado glories and play for a different team for a while. Or if they paid me enough, I'd even play for the Albed. You have anything else to say here, kiddo? No, same thing. Okay. Who are you? You are Zazie. Who's Zazie again? Let me pop that. I think that's the goalie. Blitzball agents. Let's just scroll down. Zazie Guado is the glories. Yeah, okay, that didn't help. Is he the goalie? Stats. That's Zamzy. No. Okay, so Zazie, I don't know what you are. I could just do the other one. Okay, this will be quick. Bear with me. Where's the football stats? Z-A-Z-I. You are... Shoe.
really good speed, so you can outrun defenders. That's sad for me. But let's put Zazie as possibility. You said you want to play for somebody else, so... Zazie Watto plays for... But mentions wanting to play for another team for a change. Sure. We'll think about you. I'll consider you. You're only a 90 gale a game is pretty good. So you play for the Besaid Orcs. You're Titus, right? I saw you at the tournament. Let's split some time. Those fiends really made a mess. Some of my teammates were badly hurt. Who are you? Pogwato. 10 gil a game? You are a passer and attacker. Oh, and your block gets super high at the end. Cool stuff. It's supposed to be... Is there something in here? Hold on. In the residence, there's a chest with 3,000 gil and Albed primer in the cabinet in the middle. Chest! Aha! 3,000 gil. This looks like it might be a primer. There we go. Cool. S equals M. I got a new rank. I didn't look at what it said, though. Eh. Treasure chest behind a group of Guado. There's a group of Guado. Treasure chest up here? No. I still got time. Unless this Farplane thing is like 30 minutes long. What do you gotta say? Since embracing Yavin, we gotta have learned the joy that is Blitzball. Which one are you? Aura? I suppose you think we look odd, don't you? That's fine, we Guado are used to that sort of thing. Never said anything. But if you ask me, you humans look absolutely disgusting. Still, what does it matter? Such nonsense beneath us now. I don't know where their goalie... there's a free agent goalie somewhere in here. Yuma, I believe? Rim or the far plane is sacrosanct. Proper conduct, please. You're not. Yeah, honorable. Alright. We are up another ramp here. Keep going up, up, up. There's some kind of pyre flies floating around. Hold on. There was a door down here. No, there wasn't. Never mind. Stick to the left walls or hidden chest. Oh, hold on. Down here. Lightning marble times 8. Thank you, guide. You wouldn't find these things unless you're like, oh, every single time there's like a hidden part of the map, I should go and
question
click on it.
Question about this far plane. When somebody dies, a summoner sends them to the far plane, right? So their souls, or whatever they are, they go to the far plane, right?
Okay, so we are... The ramp... Like, there's a hallway ramp that led us to this. There's a stairway that kind of is, like... Looks kind of worn and ancient. Kind of greenish stairs. As if maybe moss or something
but
on them.
But that's the far plane we're going to,
almost
right?
As if it's made of...
And Yuna's old man's there, too?
Tree?
Do dead people live there or something?
Titus is in the dark screen with some scary soul thing. Yeah.
You thinking those funny thoughts again, yeah?
I think that's his imagination. Yeah. We got a glimpse.
You'll see once we get there.
Oh.
Aren't you coming?
I do not belong there.
You're scared.
Searching the past to find the future. This is all that is there. I need it not. You'd better be going.
You're not really going to see the dead. More like your memories of them. People think of their relatives, and the pyreflies react to them. They take on the form of the dead person. An illusion, nothing else. Well, have fun.
What? You're not going either, Riku?
I keep my memories inside.
Huh?
Memories are nice, but But that's all they are. See you later. See you later.
You're still here.
Yeah, you guys are so nice. And you're going up the ramp, up the, like, the tree ramp, basically, into a giant circular, kind of like convex portal. Purpley, glowy lights, kind of like the northern lights. A bunch of different colors. It looks like you're walking through oil and water, so, like, all the colors. Yeah. And now we're in a low quality FMB, but Titus is walking on just ground. Walk is here talking to somebody who kind of looks like him.
What the?
Eunice here talking to, I would assume, Lord Braska and her mother. Eric and Kamari, they're outside already. And it's just one platform, and there's a swirling cloud vortex just everywhere else. But now we're kind of seeing inside the swirls, and there's, like, waterfalls and beautiful terrain. Beautiful waterfalls. Very wide. All falling into this, like, valley of multicolored flowers. There seems to be some kind of moon-like object in the sky.
The Farplane was cool, but I couldn't stop thinking about Yuna. Her parents, they looked so happy together, but it got me worried that maybe seeing them would make Yuna really consider Seymour's proposal.
Let's see what Kamari here says. Just shakes his head. Oh, I guess that's to prevent you from leaving. What's up, Waka?
Yo, Chapu! Meant to come see you earlier, yeah? Sorry. I know you won't hold it against me.
Chapu looks a lot like Waka, just a little bit thinner. Similar hair.
I gave up that game. I'm a guardian from here on, you know? This guy looks a lot like you. Showed up. Traveling with him, I thought maybe you were still alive somewhere, yeah? But then again, here you are on the far plane. Guess your place is here. So, how you been? Oh, that guy I just told you about? I gave him your sword. He likes it.
Huh? Whoa.
Titus is holding the sword and... let's go talk to him.
Just a sec more.
Okay, so did he actually... I was told that he would give me, like, the power to... Oh, that's why I couldn't modify it, because now it has... Strength plus 5%, strength plus 10%, water strike and sensor. That's insane. And here for it. Okay. Okay. Let's talk to Lulu. Or go approach
he
Lulu.
He is dead, and I am still alive.
She's watching Chopper.
Coming here really makes that clear. I should focus more on what I have to do now.
What?
I'm not even sure what I'm saying.
Don't you mean that you should leave Chapu behind? I'm sure he was a great guy, but there'll be others.
That's a possibility.
How about Waka?
What, me? With Waka?
Yeah, you two get along great.
Getting along isn't enough. Not even close.
Oh, sorry. My mistake.
You'd do well to remember that. Knowing a bit about women might come in handy someday.
Ew.
Yeah, I'll remember.
I won't be forgetting either. Goodbye, Chapu. You always said I looked grumpy. But those were the happiest days of my life.
Okay. Approach Yuna.
So, Yuna?
I've decided.
Really? That's good.
I remember, when I was only 7 years old, in Bavel that day. My father had defeated Sin, and the whole town was out in the streets. Everyone was laughing. They all seemed so happy. If I defeated Sin, that would make everyone happy, wouldn't it? I must do what everyone wants. not just what I want.
Let's go back. You gotta tell Seymour.
Before that, call Sir Jet. Give it a try.
Huh?
Don't worry. He won't come.
Trying not to think about my old man made me think about him, of course.
See, told you.
He isn't here because he's not dead. He's Sin.
That means he's alive, you know.
What if my old man really is Sin? What would I say to Yuna? Heck, to everybody in Spira. Wait, why should I have to apologize for him anyway?
I'd rather never see him again.
What makes you hate him so?
Everything he does just makes me mad. It was his fault that me and my mother...
Mom?
It's her.
She's very pretty.
But wait, no one ever performed the sending for her.
She must have accepted death while she was still alive.
Whoa there. That's my mother you're talking about.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. I think I just figured something out.
What?
Why I hate my old man.
Screen flashes white.
See, so I told him what I thought of him right there.
What, really?
Of course.
I suppose, but... Mommy!
Just a sec, dear.
Whenever my old man was around, my mother wouldn't even look at me.
Maybe that's when I started to resent him, even hate him. When he left us,
Mom just lost her energy.
Is she all right?
Why should you care?
If she dies, I wouldn't know what to do.
Don't say Mom is gonna die.
I apologize.
The old lady next door told me,
when a lovebird dies, the one left behind,
it just gives up living so it can join its mate. It was just like that. I hated my old man even more.
This is just a flashback.
But really, my old man...
Young
Mommy! Baby.
Just a sec, dear.
Go to him. He'll cry if you don't.
Just young Titus on their houseboat.
Oh, man. I must sound so stupid.
Present.
So. I don't think so.
How embarrassing.
Well, need some more time.
No. I'm ready.
Did I miss something?
Thanks for waiting. I'll go give my answer to Maester Seymour.
Lord Jiskal!
Oh, Lord Jiskal!
A spirit trying to leave the Farplane.
He does not belong here.
Why?
Yuna, send him.
Orin falls to his knees.
Lord Jiskal!
He is Lord Jiskal no more. Send him now.
Yuna starts to perform the sending dance, and Jiskal kind of stumbles, or like kind of shocks into like a very upright form, and his soul leaves like in one of those kind of firefly sparkles.
Talk later. We leave now.
And something drops from him.
What was that just now? That really Lord Jiskal?
I don't understand how a man like Lord Jiskal can die and not be sent.
I would think that he was sent once, but he stayed on Spira. Something, a powerful emotion, could have bound him to this world, Such things happen.
That's against the rules, isn't it?
It means he died an unclean death.
Hmm. Okay. Go back down some ramps here. There's a dude running up and down some of these ramps. I think it was one of the blitzers. Oh, everybody's gone. Okay, so let's go down this ramp again. We got the group here. Another cutscene thing.
I will go meet with Maester Seymour.
Yuna! Jisco is the Guado's problem, not yours.
What?
So, Lulu, what do you think about Yuna getting married?
As long as the pilgrimage continues, either way's fine.
That's it? What if she doesn't even like the guy? Is that okay?
People marry for many reasons.
What's that mean?
Sometimes marriage doesn't require love, you know? Defeat sin and bring joy to the people of Spira. Get married and bring joy to the people of Spira. For Yuna, they're just two ways down the same road.
All you need is determination.
If you have that, you don't need love.
I don't know. I just don't get it.
Oh, this guy, it's called endurance training. Stay out of my way. Wait, who are you? Wait, come back. He is Nav Guado. I would assume that means he has high endurance? I don't know. But endurance is like a measure of how much tackle you can take, basically. What's up, Horn?
We leave as soon as Yuna returns. I trust you'll be ready.
Yes, ma'am. Lulu again.
Listen, if Yuna gets married, then I...
What? That again?
Yes. If she is to marry, I would want her to marry for love.
See?
But, if Yuna said she wanted to marry the one she loves, I would have to object.
Huh? You're not making much sense.
I know.
She's talking about you, dummy.
Lulu, I've talked enough about that.
What?
I'm sorry, just forget about it.
Jeez, grumpy.
You'll understand one of these days. I just don't want to give it words, not yet. I shouldn't have to say this, but don't fall in love with her.
Too late.
I see, but you must keep your feelings inside until the pilgrimage is over.
Okay, Dr. Baca.
For a while there, I was a little worried about what was gonna happen, yeah?
I'm a little worried about Lord Jiskal. I wonder if Maester Seymour has heard. Leave the Guado's problems to the Guado, they say. Leave the Guado's...
That's it for her. Where's Riku? Oh, where are you? Lord Jiskal came back. Don't you find it intriguing? Scary. What's in here? I've been in here before. Kamari was in there.
Guado potions, good. Buy some before leaving.
Okay. I guess this is a shop. I've been in here before. Awaka, what's up, bud?
Ah!
Got it.
Thank you.
Weapons? Smart, but it's all at 23. I don't want to. I'll just take. take the damage. Yeah. Stone Touch, I think that comes in handy later, so I'm gonna keep it. Shimmering Blade, I got better now.
Guado merchants are shrewd.
Ripping off the pilgrims that come to visit the Farplane. Listen, you watch that they don't get you too. Me you can trust. More than a Guado, at least. What do you say?
Because lightning ward things are cheaper. Cool. What about items? What do you got for items, bud? Oh, more expensive than Waka. Thank you, Kamari. Kamari was wrong. You got duped, Kamari. Although, you share my guild, so...
When we leave here, we have to go through the Thunder Plains next, you know? I can't stand thunder.
Thank you. Please tell no one about Lord Driscoll's wife. If word leaked out that the Lord of the Guado and the Maester of Yevon wandered from the Farplane, we Guado would become the laughingstock of all Spira. Yevon have mercy on us. Okay, I already talked to you. You are Guerra Guado. What about you? What do you got to say? No, not you. Maybe Lord Seymour knows why. After all, he is Lord Driscoll's blood. Why Lord Driscoll? You gave him such a warm sending. Why Lord Driscoll? Running out of time here. Who are you? Everyone's talking about Lady Yuna, how she's the daughter of High Summoner Braska. She fought alongside Lord Seymour during Operation Meehan, right? Correct. Thou seemest weary, good traveler. Wouldst sit and rest thy feet a while? Belike my speech perplexes thee. 'Tis old Guado I speak, a tongue seldom heard within even Guadosalam now, for good reason. Good traveler, prithee forgive us our antiquated pride. Elders just won't give up the old tongue. I keep telling them how unseemly it is, babbling like that to guests. Here's Yuma. I think I should have... Ooh. Can I? So Yuma is cheaper than Miyu. Yuma is also worse than Mew for like the first 70 levels, but only by like a couple points here and there, but you know, a couple points can make a difference. So, here's what it is. Let's try going, I think we have to try going to the Thunder Plane, which is not this direction. Hold on. Navigating this thing sometimes is very annoying. Go this way, and then try to go to the Thunder Plane here.
My! Is the Lady Summoner not with you?
Walking up.
No, she's at Seymour's place.
That's Maester Seymour, or Lord Seymour.
Oh, I'll be careful. Sorry.
That's all right. Oh, Maester Seymour left Guadosalam a short while ago.
You serious?
I believe he went to the temple in Makalania. Maester Seymour is also the high priest of that temple.
Whoa! I gotta tell the others!
You're approaching a good safe point pretty soon here. So is Orin and everybody else. You are animatedly telling them what you just heard. That leaves the question, where is Yuna? We are inside...
Lord Jisco, please, tell me. What can I do to help?
Inside...
Yuna, let's go!
Maester Seymour's residence thing. Or the... Seymour, the... I don't know. Whatever. Lord Jisco was one of, like, the paintings, quote-unquote, on the wall. Green background, kind of muted painting of the person's face.
They say Seymour went to Macarena Temple.
Macalania Temple.
I?
What I don't get is, why would the Lord Maester head off without a peep to anyone?
I don't think I got that.
Maybe
joke.
He wasn't expecting Yuna's answer so soon.
That's probably it.
Yuna, what is it?
Oh, nothing.
You're a poor liar.
It's true, it's nothing. Come on, let's go.
Time to double save. Should I? Okay, let's see if I can customize anybody's weapon or stuff in the way here. First off, hold on. What are people wearing? So, Shimmering Blade for Orin. Could have something added to it. And Riku's weapon, Devastator, could have something added to it, and Variable Mog, and so Lulu's Variable Mog and Tough Bangle. Okay. Customize. So that's Titus, Shimmering Blade. I can do Strength plus 3, but then I would not be able to do Strength plus 10 when I can finally do that. So let's not do that. Poison touch. She doesn't have any accuracy, so she could miss with that more often than not. And but her tough angle could have. Oh, so that's why they gave me 8 lightning marbles. I could make somebody lightning proof. And making Yuna lightning proof would be a smart move. HP 20% she has right now. Auto med automatically uses items to cure status ailments, so that takes 20 remedies. Good thing I've been stealing them from the Ochu, Ochu's. Okay, I won't do that yet, I'm gonna wait for something better. Riku, however, I could give. More magic, I think that would help when she uses the mix. I'll have to test it. Figure out how to test that without. And then magic plus 5 on your mog here. Once again, I think I could wait and give magic plus 10 when that finally comes around. Okay, so I'm not going to customize anything after all. Where is that save point? Is that this way? I know there's one outside here. Is there not one inside here somewhere? You know what? Screw it. We just need someone outside here. I'm not gonna go searching around. I got no time. I got a bathroom. Okay. Save. And I might do some more leveling. Oh, there's one in the inn. Whoops. Save. Boom. Awesome. Alright. That's it for this video. I'll upload it now. Almost 50 minutes. Cool. Good way to spend my lunch, in my opinion. Bye-bye.